Hi guys, Plume here. Welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, if you're new here, welcome. I am Plume and I like to build things. So a little bit of a different intro screen for this series. Today we are on number 3 of our Building Newcrest series. If you're not familiar with it, be sure to watch episodes 1 and 2, where episode 1 was this home down here, the Zen mod, and episode 2 was this home over here, which was the Posh mod. And today we're going to be on lot number 3 of the rebuild. And as you can see, I do have 5 lots built already, and we're going to jump into one of them in just a second. But if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe if you like this video, or if you want to see more of the Building Newcrest. I put a poll out on Twitter to ask which town everyone wanted to be rebuilt, and it was Newcrest that won, and the style that won was modern. So the first two builds, like I said, they were in Llama Lagoon. There were these two builds right here, and I went ahead and jumped over to Ridgeline Drive. I am gonna make this more of a commercial community over here with some commercial lots, and so that's the first commercial lot that we will visit today in just a second. But today I wanted to pop in another Simlish phrase, and today's Simlish phrase is hubanubi. So if you know what that is, go ahead and leave a comment down below. Use it in a sentence, even if you don't know what it is. Go ahead and try to guess. Leave it in a comment down below, and at the end of the video I will reveal what it means. So let's jump right into our next build, which is our first commercial build in this series, and it is here on the Rippling Flats lot in Ridgeline Drive community. It's a 30 by 20 lot, and it is a cafe, as you can see by the description. The lot traits are study spot, university hangout, and teen neighborhood. And here we are. So this is Cafe Mod, our first commercial lot in our Newcrest rebuild, and I am super pleased with the way that it came out. I have been wanting to do a little cafe, and I thought, what better time than now to go ahead and do it in this rebuild series. So this is the exterior. As you can see, it is very modern, again keeping with the theme. I am obsessed with the chevron wallpaper from, I believe it's the bowling pack, and I had looked a lot on Pinterest for some inspiration on a cafe that would lean towards a more modern style. And I saw a picture, and I'll try to put it up in editing if I can find it on my Pinterest feed if I saved it. And the exterior had these really beautiful slats over the top of it, and it really just reminded me of this awning from Eco Lifestyle. And so what I did here on the top is I just sized it up and used that to be like a little patio covering, and I am super happy with the way that it turned out. I did have to finagle the wall here a little bit, but I'm really just happy with it. So this is it. This is the exterior. We have some parking, of course, encouraging the eco lifestyle. We have some bicycle parking here. There is some seating outside in the front, where you would walk along the walkway to get to the entrance. I did play test this, so that is why there are plates out, but I kind of like that it adds a little bit. Seems like someone was here. So we have the big sign over here, letting people know, of course, that it is a cafe and a restaurant, and to come on in. So I'm gonna switch over to tab mode. I had to come out of the game a second ago because it updated, and I completely forgot to put the build tab mod back in to the folder. So here's the entrance. I just love it. Sized up the plant there, and love the little window that's open. Over here is a play area for kids, because I do want it to be a family-friendly cafe. Little security camera. There's a swing set and a ball pit, everyone's favorite ball pit, and a slide for the kiddos. So walking through the front door, I wanted it, of course, to be modern, but I also wanted it to be warm and inviting. I didn't want it to be ultra modern or sparsely decorated. I really wanted it to have a little bit of life and warmth to it. So we went ahead and hung up all of these string lights. I think they are so fun, and I want them in real life. And so there's a nice little sitting area whenever you first come into the cafe with a lot of hanging plants. Of course, the window boxes are there as well, lots of greenery, the string lights, and then of course you have a little area with a trash can, and I imagined it as the place where you would get your straws and utensils and things like that. And of course some free samples, because who doesn't love free samples? And then over here, which would be to the left of the entrance whenever you first walked in, it's just another little sitting area, lots of windows, again, more greenery, more hanging plants, and of course that is the exit door to get to the outside play area for the kids. This is the queue, and there are two little menus here to the sides that let you know kind of what's going on today, what the specials of the day are, and what all wonderful coffee drinks and non-coffee drinks are available. Do you guys drink coffee? Are you guys tea drinkers? Do you like both? I tend to really just like coffee. It's just what I was introduced to, and I tend to love it. So, and the darker the better. I know that they say that the light brews have more caffeine in them, which is something I did not know until just a couple years ago, but I do find myself being more gravitated towards coffee. And as you can see over here to each side of the counter, we do have a unisex bathroom. Okay, and if we head on up the stairs off to each side of the counter, there's a little landing here with a bookshelf with some books and reading material, and you could sit here and still be inside and enjoying the ambiance of the cafe itself while having a little bit of privacy to yourself, maybe to study, bring your laptop. And here we have our exterior patio, so ample seating for everyone to come and enjoy these beautiful days in Newcrest. And of course, in the winter, you could stick a little heater out here somewhere so that they could enjoy it outside as well in the different seasons. But the patio offers such a beautiful view of Newcrest. There's just something about Newcrest. It really does have some stunning views, so you can enjoy the view of the park over here, and of course also enjoy from this side the views of the beautiful homes that are in Newcrest and the bustling busy cities. And like I said, this is the 30 by 20 rippling flats lot in Newcrest. That's the one that's going to fit the best in if you download it from the gallery, and I am planning on having a save file once the modern Newcrest rebuild is done, so let me know if you guys would be interested in that. And the lot value is $86,297. Of course, again, the traits are Steady Spot, University Hangout, and Teen Neighborhood, and it's plate tested fine. I didn't have any issues with it. Here is an overview of the first floor. So there are two bathrooms, one on each side of the cafe. There's plenty of trash receptacles, some registers, of course the counter where the Sims will order, and they didn't seem to bottleneck here or anything like that. Of course the seating here and the little counter. And yeah, so that's pretty much it, guys. There will be some still shot tours of the build coming up in just a few seconds, so I hope you stick around for that. See some detail shots of the build. Super happy with the way that Newcrest is turning out so far. If you prefer this style of the build tours when we're doing the Newcrest build, be sure to give this video a thumbs up or let me know in the comments down below. So for today's phrase of the day, it was hooba noobie, which is what's up in Simlish. So again, that's just the unofficial Simlish dictionary online. But did you guys know what that meant? Let me know in the comments down below. Try to use it in a sentence. And yeah, so be kind, love one another, and I will catch you guys later.